Has it really been a year since the last AV therapy? Oh, I better not leave it this long next time. Let's see how I remember how to do this or not. 2 minutes starting now. 15 years ago, I was exposed to video conference technology and it absolutely blew my mind that I could be talking to someone anywhere in the world and see their face and see what's actually going on in the space that they're in. And over the last 15 years, I've been trying to champion the idea of using video conference technology in the home, in the workplace, to bring people together over distances. What we saw with COVID is the absolute pressure to go into a situation like that, the pressure cooker that brings innovation. We saw people jump to Zoom, to Skype, to Teams, to Google Meets, and a whole heap of other platforms, including Pexip, Poly, Cisco, I could go on for days, I won't, that actually connect people from being at home. And we learned what we could actually do with our remote workforce. Today, in the last 24 hours, Google has released something that I really think brings video conferencing into the next dimension, literally by going three-dimensional with Project Starline. Project Starline, not Starlight, as I just said, is a 3D acquisition, neural net, all the stuff they've learned to bring 3D volumetric, face-to-face, eye-to-eye communication over the internet using regular networks. It is absolutely outstanding. But not to be forgotten is DVE telepresence, which I knew from about 10, 15 years ago, which are now DVE holographics, who have been doing this for a very long time with a mixture of technologies from Mylar screens with projection and screens beneath it, right through to translucent displays from other manufacturers. They've been doing this for a very, very long time. Still a very, very cool and relevant technology. What we're actually seeing with the technology from Google as well is stuff like what was around a few years ago from a company called CatchEye, who developed a way of taking your face and remapping it in real time to make sure that you have that eye-to-eye contact without having a teleprompter set up like I have here today. I'll leave links in the description below to actually see this video, to see what that experience is like. And you will see that, you know what, I've been doing this not for a long time, but I haven't done it for a year. So that horn never gets any quieter. I'd love to hear what your thoughts are on this and where you are with your video conference journey in the comments below. Till next time, I'll see you on AV Therapy next episode.